Let's go.
Please come in, sir. This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We were just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big. But his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we can take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle?
Come on, Arthur.
Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
Can I drive?
Nope.
Ready? Let's get out of here.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of hers. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. The smug fucker.
Okay. So what's she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep, using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting, she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook now, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right fella for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. But there really better be some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Do you even know where we're headed?
Easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still, tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way.
You sure this is the right way?
They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. You're taking us the wrong way. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery, that's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then. Yep.
Can't you go any faster? Drive on the road, for Christ's sake.
Going to wreck the wagon.
back on the road.
What now, smart arse?
A second. Are you not worried about them greys, English?
Excuse me?
You not worried about them greys?
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Yeah, maybe you're right. You know what? Here. I'll go hiding back. If you can act naturally and stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
I'm not going to go that far.
I'll do the talking.
Hey, hold him right there.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal, in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there,
okay.
They said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink. Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? Then you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said they was looking for more drivers in town. I jumped at the chance. I ain't never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. Bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horse is like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy, because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh? Okay. We can hold up in here till it gets dark.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine, and then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained. And that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
They should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was born burning down manor houses.
We'll burn quietly.
Thank you.
want the Greys to know we're coming. What the hell? Stop shooting, you crazy bastard! Oh, that'll really throw him off the scent.
For Christ's sake.
For Christ's sake, just put the gun away.
That horse don't listen.